Sorry about that. Had to take care of something really quick. Chance. I probably should have gotten into shelter. Gonna do this. Am I perhaps not? I don't think I'm picking the armor again. That might be my problem. Must not be picking the armor again. Okay, there. Got the armor now. Sorry about that again. Thank you. Oh, that's a new one. Left. Stupid pinkies. All right. My shockwave must have finished up. What's in Future Slam? We did it.
And you will be the savior. Your strength will be their shield, and your will their sword. You remain unbroken, for your might is eternal.
When that happened to the moon? I blew up Mars. All right. So yeah, fun game. I don't know what else to say besides that, but Iconoclast. All right. Oh, I like these images on the side. Me ripping somebody up from below. I'm gonna see pictures of crew and such. This game was a lot longer than the first one. It's like double length, the first one. I don't know if that's necessarily a good thing, because I kind of burned out after a while. But other than the burnout, I enjoyed this game very much. I was surprised at how much they were able to bring new to the table. The new monsters and the old one, new demons and old, even the old demons. The flamethrower. I like the flamethrower, even though I took forever for me to get used to using it. The missiles. All the buttons did something, but they were indicated on the screen, so if you forgot what did what, then you could remember. I remember having a real problem up till past the middle of the game, where I kept hitting the L1 button to bring up, it's the R1 button to bring up the weapon wheel, but I kept hitting L1 and shooting a grenade. Artwork was good. I liked the story. I didn't really read through the data log things that they gave me because I didn't have enough time to read them all. But this game seems like one that I could probably get a lot of easy trophies with if I play through it right. I got plenty on the way through. I don't know if I could ever platinum this, because I know it has an online multiplayer. And I don't really see me playing the online. I know this has DLC, but the DLC is very expensive for what's worth, and besides, I'm a little burned out anyway, so even if I had the money, I'd probably wait. I don't know if I will eventually get to the DLC, but I might. For now, I think I'm going to replace Doom Eternal with Catherine, the full body definitive edition for the Switch. But that's for next time. For now, I'll let all of this play through, and there's a lot of different voice actors. Doom Hunter, Dave Boat. That's right, the Doom Hunter did talk. And then he became... I kind of like that, too, how the Doom Hunter and the Tyrant and the, and the thing on the tank. The thing on the tank with the shields, and the guy that summoned the dog and had his own big shield. I like how they all went from being bosses at the end of a stage to just being regular enemies. That was kind of neat. But anyway, I'll let this play through. See if there's anything post-credits. And then I'll obviously call it there. Till then, though, until next time, thank you very much for watching. If you like this video, please give me a like. Share, comment, subscribe. It always helps me out. And as always, have a good day, and take care.
beyond.